For 4 weeks we were marching. That was in January, and we were not dressed for.
What were you wearing?
I think I wore just a dress, and maybe a sweater I had on. Where I got the sweater, I don't know.
What dress was this? What kind of dress was this?
That was the dress that we still got in Auschwitz. From time to time in Auschwitz, we went for showers, and they changed this. And because we were full of lies and things like that, you know, they were. We went on, and it was winter time, and we walked through forests. I think we did like 35 kilometers every day, and the Nazi beast on their horses accompanying us and urging us go on.
What happened to the people who couldn't?
And we couldn't walk. You couldn't walk. They just—they were shot. And sometimes we tried to help someone too who couldn't walk. But we were like, every one of us were like half corpses ourselves. Like we could hardly carry our legs. We were not. We were starved and humiliated and frightened. And the snow was put a blanket over our freezing bodies.
Where did you think you were going?
I don't know. But we met quite a number of groups like that on the way, men and who could hardly drag their feet.
Were they going in the same direction?
Yeah, I mean, if I was going this way, they were going that way. You know, like, but we were not far from each other. I guess they went to other places, other lagers, because it was like the German says, they say it was an isolated something. I think there was 80 camps, 80 concentration camps in Germany itself, besides Poland and besides other places. So in almost every little area was a concentration camp, and they were used to seeing us, and nobody, and then I lost a shoe or I whatever, I don't know what happened, but I had to wrap my feet in some rags, and that's how I marched on. And
where'd you get the rags?
We tore off from the dress pieces or from my sweater or something too. And we were, at night we rested in barns. And one of the places where we rested, I found a pair of wooden shoe, and I just went there and took it without thinking. And then the owner of this barn reported it to the Nazi animal, and so he made an announcement right away. Whoever took a pair of shoes should come right away, you know, report. If not, many of them. Of you will be shot. Well, of course, I didn't want any because of my account that other innocent people should be punished. I went there. I went in front of him, and he started with his revolver hitting me on my neck and head and back until I fainted. When I woke, then I saw. Before I fainted, the woman who reported this missing told him to stop. So then he stopped. And I woke up, I was told that I was the inmates pulled me and back to the group. But when I woke up, I wasn't happy because when I was, I felt so good after I lost consciousness. I didn't know any more of this earth's misery. And when I came to myself, I was crying and crying that the suffering will start all over again. And by this time, we pretty much knew that all people who loved me and I loved and I cared for are not among the living. So there was no pull that I should go on. So I was disappointed that they brought me back, that I was brought back to consciousness.